Good morning, everybody. It's me, David Richards, your worship leader this morning on July 12th in the year of our Lord 2020. Now, I need you to push the pause button. It's those two little lines down at the bottom left of the screen. And then when you come back, after you get a candle and light it, push the play button again. So I'll be right back. Hi, I'm back. I've got my candle. I'm going to try to light it now. And I hope you're lighting your candle. And remember that for our worship time here, that this is the light of Christ. So, I have to admit to you all that preparing for this type of service, this online service, is quite a bit different than usual. Well, when I'm leading a service at church, I'm always uplifted before the service starts by seeing all of you, by talking with you, by listening to the various conversations taking place, watching you all greet each other, giving and getting hugs, listening to the music being practiced, seeing the smiling faces smiling back at me. Well, let's take a moment while I go to that place in my mind and you go to your place where we have some peace, some joy, some quiet place where we can open our heart to God's love, that vacant place in our mind where God can fill us up with His will for our lives. Take a deep breath, slowly in, slowly out. Release your pain, your sorrow, your anxiety, and your worry. Breathe in that breath of God, open to new possibilities, new ways of sharing, new ways of caring, new ways of being the light of God for this community and this world. Let us pray. Through dreams and visions, O God, you broaden the horizon and hope of your people, that we may discover the meaning of your covenant, even in the midst of trial and exile. Increase the number of those who believe in your word, so that all people, may joyfully respond to your call and share in your promises. Amen. Now, in our traditional service, we'd have an opening hymn right about now. But unlike Pastor Deb, I wasn't blessed with the singing gene. So I suggest that if you want to see as well as hear the video, that you hit the pause button again, you know, those two little lines. And then after, you have to hit the play button. It's a little triangle thing. That you can go to YouTube and search for the song Thy Word by Amy Grant, or just listen here.
Thank you.
Thank you, Amy. I've chosen the following passage from the book of Isaiah as the Bible reading this morning. It's chapter 55, verses 10 through 13. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose and succeed in the thing for which I sent it. For you shall go out in joy and be led back in peace. The mountains and the hills before you shall burst into song, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Instead of the thorn shall come up the cypress. Instead of the briar shall come up the myrtle. And it shall be to the Lord for a memorial, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. This morning's reflection, or should I call it a refraction, I'm going to explain a little bit about this passage, and then I'm going to read something very special. So in this passage from Isaiah, God is explaining that just as rain and snow, which he provides, nourishes the earth, and he doesn't recall that life-giving water and to him until it has fulfilled its purpose, so too God sends his word to us, and it shall not return to God empty, but it shall succeed. The reason God sent it will be fulfilled. Those are pretty powerful words of assurance. These words that God has sent to us, to you and to me, we need to keep sharing and keep sharing and keep sharing until God's word of love and light are shared with everyone. Now, my daughter, Nicole, shared this poem with me last month, and I hope it will touch you as much as it has touched me. It's entitled The Light and the Prism. And she wrote this, she sent this to me in June, and here's her preamble to the poem. She began writing this poem after the decision from the special session of General Conference of the United Methodist Church in 2019. That decision chose to continue excluding LGBTQ plus people from full inclusion in the United Methodist Church. I'm sharing this now, this is Nicole writing, during Pride Month, which was June, to remind people that try as we might, God's love is too big, too broad, and too bold to comprehend or explain. God's love is for all, and I hope I read it and do it justice. The light and the prism. God's love is like the light that goes through a prism. The prism scatters the light, and we, as humans, can only see a portion of it. Some see blues and greens, others see yellows and oranges. Some even see from the reds all the way to the blues. Yet none of us can see the whole spectrum from infrared to ultraviolet. We only see a portion. Even our names for the colors lack a basis in truth. What does yellow truly mean? It means something to us, but we have created this word for this thing we experience as yellow. There is no yellow in nature. Indeed, what I see as yellow, you might see as yellow-orange. And where does yellow end and orange begin? We could say the change happens at a certain wavelength, but this is only an attempt to explain something that is beyond our complete grasp. This is how it is with God's love. We seek to understand and explain what God's love is, but we are stuck trying to understand the whole from the sum of its many parts, leaving us far short from understanding the mystery of the whole, how big, how broad, and how bold God's love is for us. before it reaches a prism, white light is invisible to us. And after the prism transforms it, there's a beautiful spectrum of color. The red cannot exist without the blue, nor the green without the purple. If we shine a light with only red and blue wavelengths back through a prism, do we return to the white light? No, not even close. Why then do we persist with our convictions that God's love is only red or only blue, when God's love is all colors and no colors simultaneously? I choose to appreciate the colors I see, the proof that God's love is big and broad and bold. I choose to appreciate that others see different colors than I do. I choose to believe in the oneness of all the colors, that God's love is complete and open to all. Like I said, written by Nicole Richards in 2020. I have a beautiful graphic that she also sent me that has this poem in the background with a prism in the foreground. And I'm happy to email that to anybody who asks for it. God's love is too big, too broad, and too bold to comprehend or explain. God's love is for all. Thank you, Nicole. Love you. Let's pray. Creator God, you call us to love and serve you with body, mind, and spirit through loving your creation and all of our sisters and brothers. Open our hearts in compassion and receive these petitions on behalf of the needs of the church and the world. Lord, we pray for those affected by the COVID virus. We pray for those who are hungry. We pray for those who have bounty that they may be a blessing to those in need. Lord, we pray for those whose lives have been affected by bigotry, by racism, by hatred. Help us all to see that your love is too big, too broad, and too bold to comprehend or explain. But your love is for all. Lord, we pray for those who you have taken from us to be with you in heaven. Give us the courage to face each day and each one of earthly life's challenges, knowing that with you, all things are possible. Holy One, hear our prayers and make us faithful stewards of the fragile bounty of this earth, so that we may be entrusted with the riches of heaven. Amen. At this time, I'd like to ask you to join with me in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Now, remember to be the light. And have a blessed week. And remember to be the light to the whole world. Amen.